Thank you. I think Vikram and the gang set the context of crucification, I imagine, in some fashion or the other. So I shall accept that with a great amount of humility. Sam and Vikram clearly told me, when you come here to speak, do not share what you have done with many different markets in the last week. We've been around, going around different cities of India, giving people an update of what's happening on television and what's happening with BARC. So not going to give you too many statistics. And I was deeply tempted to actually share with all of you some of the softer qualitative work that we do, which is not backed by, which is not the hardened ratings base. But maybe there's another occasion for that. So here's what, I hope in 10 minutes, I want to leave you behind with. Just let's begin with some, you know, what I call tiny tales of 2019. FMCG had the highest volume of advertising on television over the last few years. 57% of the ad volume was fast-moving consumer goods. It was a record year for news viewership. 4 out of all 5 big viewership events of the last 4 years happened in 2019. I think you can count the 4. 2 were the aggression with our neighbor. 1 was the election, and 1 was about the floods, right, which took place across the country. We had the heaviest rainfall in the last 4 years. So it was about that. Those were the 4 big news events that took place. In IPL, the top 5 most watched matches are all where Mumbai Indian plays. So every time Mumbai Indian plays, engagement on IPL really, really goes up. And Tamil GEC has the highest number of advertisers across all other language categories, right? So there's already a large volume of advertising in Tamil Nadu, but it really has the largest category or largest set of advertisers. These are just some tiny tales because I'm not sure if all of us really are attuned to this. The Telugu movie, Smart Shankar, was the highest rated at 14.4. Yes, there was a time when movies used to get 40% and 50%, but you know, this is a high at all times. So something worth thinking about next time Pongal or around that happens. And football, which many, we believe, young people like, it's only 3% of all TV viewership. But more than half of its viewership are from markets of Kerala, Assam, Northeast Sikkim. And interestingly, small anecdote, but mixed martial arts and tennis has more than 45% of women watching that game very intensely, right? So this is just to tell you that there are some interesting stories sitting in that landscape, which perhaps get brushed under in the larger scheme of things. So since IPL is coming up and it's the season for cricket coming up soon, it really was a huge year of advertising. And that really happened because of so many languages that the broadcaster put the match out on. I think, if I'm not mistaken, the finale was played out on 17 different TV channels, right? So phenomenal uptake in terms of ads, and you can see that over there. 246 advertisers, phenomenal growth in brands and categories. So really, really huge in terms of numbers over there. 424 million viewers on television alone, which was an increase, and 1.58 billion impressions. So that was huge. 5 of the topmost games were all games in which Mumbai Indian played. We talk of television at a macro level and at a large level, but you should look at it in terms of what's been growing over the last 4 years. Bhojpuri shows high growth, maybe a small genre. Bengali again shows high growth. Malayalam shows high growth. Punjabi shows high growth, and Gujarati shows high growth. This is all volume growth of advertising. I'm not talking viewership. I'm talking about where brands are investing and where their growth is coming from, right? And this is now spread across India. So Bhojpuri, Bengal, east and center of India, Malayalam in the south, Punjab in the north, and Gujarat in the west. So you can just see where that growth is coming from. And that's where, that's what driving some of the economics. And if you look at where that growth is coming from, sports, kids, movies, music, news, the other. So it's really sports, kids, music, which have got high growth areas of the last few years. I know overall, volume of advertising was muted. It was reasonably the same as 2018. But this is where the growth is coming from. So these are indicators of where you could expect growth in 2020 and onwards. So I'm going to talk of some things that we are doing, which is not about these numbers, but just some of the newer things that Vikram was keen we focus on. So I know that there are enough and high quality media planners and media buyers who know how to plan this on television. We actually work with a few agencies and clients to look not just as targeting women, but at targeting specific cohorts. So the client's brief has been that, you know, I've got a specific cohort. I want to look at how this cohort is viewing television. I want to place my ads basis that cohort. And the cohort could be their mother of toddlers, mother of preteens, so on and so forth. They will assign certain behavior variables as to what they purchase, what they buy, what they think is there in the shopping basket. And we help clients track that data, right? This is not publicly available. This is designed, and we are doing this for a few customers to understand what those clients want, working closely with the agency which evolves that plan and works with us to create these cohorts. So if you want to sell a car, or you want to sell toothpaste, or you want to sell a financial loan, there's a way to define those cohorts. It sits in the data. We're able to work that data. We add to the research that we do, and we build this cohort so it helps clients plan their TV programs sharper, better, and more effectively. So because these are things not in the public domain that I'd like to share it here, if people are interested, that's always a way to look at TV differently. Vikram spoke of ACOM, and he spoke of looking at video. So we look at video from a lens of how to make this a successful breakthrough in 2020. And we have kicked off what we call a multi-screen project. It starts from the broadcasters, because if you are sitting here and there is some news that breaks, you are likely to go to your phone, you are likely to look for that video event of that news, and you want to see it. So there's content which is sitting of a broadcaster on other platforms. It could be on YouTube, they could be sharing it with multiple device partners, it could be sitting on the app, it could be sitting in many places. We've triggered off a project to measure multi-screen viewing which emanates from a broadcaster. So it's content that starts on TV and is then carried forward and watched on different digital spectrums. So we know that screens are increasing. We know that attention span is getting diverted between television and between other forms. So we wish to address this. We are in pilot stage with broadcasters, technology partners, and measurement partners. And therefore, what will happen is that content owners will be able to curate their respective content. Advertisers will be able to build plans to sharpen this. And agencies will, of course, be able to perform significantly better. We've got a few broadcasters enrolled in this. We have a few content partners enrolled in this, a few measurement services enrolled. And I'm happy to speak to anybody who wants to reach out to me anytime during the year to put this pilot together, be it an agency, an advertiser, or a broadcaster to put this piece together. But we are going to work on this. We're going to make this such that you can add to the viewing that happens on TV. So you can do TV plus what may happen on any other platform. So you get a sigma of that, or you only want that additional. And if you're a content creator, you have an option to, you know, carve that out, monetize that separately, or monetize that together. For some people, there'll be surprises. For some people, it may or may not make a big change, right? So that's where we are headed. This is going to happen this year. It's work in progress as I speak. The second thing is on work on progress is everybody knows that our panel is of 44,000 homes. It'll go to 55,000 homes this year. We do a Broadcast India survey, which goes into 3 lakh homes, which is kicked off. But more than that is given the enforcement of digital, be it cable or be it DTH. There's a lot of data that some of the contemporary set-top boxes are giving back to the platform, to the platforms that provide this signal. So we are working with some of these platforms, both in DTH and cable, to pick this data back, get the, if I can just give it a short form, a KYC, know your customer, right? So you get the demographic data, which is built with that we would partner together. Then we're able to do 3 things. We're able to look at the long tail of certain channels, the long tail channels, which are really small and niche. 2, it really increases the virtual sample to a phenomenally bigger number. And as more partners participate, it takes that base up. And as everybody knows in the system, we are constantly being challenged. People want to guess where the box is. They want to guess what their numbers are. This morning, I was being told a story how somebody looks at certain channels' performance on YouTube and decides what's going to be BARC rating next Thursday. Brilliant. I love all of this, right? So looking at all of that, this is really to help, you know, create certain security and integrity thresholds. At present, the volume of data we sit on an annualized basis is twice that of the Aadhaar database. So there's a lot of data that is sitting there with the system. And we will grow this. We'll be able to have better reporting. We'll be able to build the sample bigger. And then we look at multiple cuts that can emerge from this. So these are, again, these are pilots which are going out there. And these pilots will have life in 2020 and definitely in 2021. Those are two things that are pilots. This is something I want to just share briefly. A lot of our colleagues in the news business use this as a dashboard, but I want to tell you the benefit as an advertiser. So we do this for news, we do this for music, we do this for GEC. So earlier news channels would sit and they would look at the data every week and then they would map it to the content and that would be a hugely laborious process. I know I have done this before. But now it's automated in a dashboard. You get to know how your content has performed. The editor knows reasonably fast what's happening, what's working. You don't actually have to wait for Thursday for this data. You could, if you want, get it earlier in the week. And therefore, you know what's moving in your news wheel and how to create that same pattern. Now, if you're an advertiser and you want a certain association with a news program, it also tells you which anchor is working for what kind of time slot and on what kind of sentiment. It also tells you when an anchor moves to a certain engagement or the newsroom moves to a certain engagement or a certain guest, what work and what don't work. So it becomes easier because very often you see when an anchor speaking, he's got a computer or something, it says Dell or some other brand, right, over there. It gives you opportunity to think of this. The same thing is in GEC. Many clients sponsor music shows, they sponsor concerts, and they sponsor dance competition and that kind of talent competition. We are able to map up with facial recognition technology embedded into the software, embedded with data, as to which character is working at what point of time. So very easy for advertisers to think of how to associate with that. And these are plug and plays. They don't sit in the standard BMW. You have to call for this data. But these are interesting ways in which data which is sitting on television can be really relevant to decisions that marketers and agencies need to make. This is a different sample. It sits for what is agreed definition of premium homes. It only works in megacities. The definition is restricted, but it's getting wide use when you want to sell to upscale audiences. The common notion is that those who are upscale watch different things. No, everybody has the same dal roti. Okay, they may watch more of a little English content, they may watch more of a little more in HD, and they watch as much television, the average household watches as much television as any others. So the statistic is 541, it's 518, it's 20 minutes less, that's all. But they're as engaged. But it gives you an opportunity to target and to think of how you want to target these audiences, right? So, and we are developing this to work with this on multi-screen too. So it'll capture what they're doing on their digital screen, and it'll capture what they're doing on television. So that's all, Vikram. I didn't repeat a single thing of what I said earlier. This place rocks. Thank you.